Okay, racers, today I've been asked how you put on these aircraft lines, the stainless steel lines on your motorcycle, because they are a bit difficult. They fit very tight, especially the Earls. I think Earls is probably the top of the line. There's several different brands. You've got the, this is a Summit, Russell, and then Aeroquip also makes one. We're gonna work with the Summit fittings. I found that the Summits or the Russells are a little bit easier to put on. The Earls are very tight, and they're a little bit more difficult to put on. So I'll show you how I do it. Okay, so now looking at the motor, you can see that I've put on dozens of fittings already. I've got one left here that needs to be hooked up, and what I've done is I've cut my hose and I put the fitting on so that the hose reaches up to where I'm going. You want to make sure that you plan this out a bit so that your lines are going to clear stuff like exhaust pipes, of course not across your seat up your ass. You want to run your lines in the best shortest distance you can, so you need to do a little bit of planning on that part. So what I'm going to do, You could spend a fortune on the special tools to do these, or you can do it this way. It's not that hard. I'm going to take a felt pen. Here's my fitting here. I've got this fitting screwed in tight where it's going to end up, and the other end of the hose on the other end of the fitting here. So I'm just going to mark my hose. The hose will only come to this part of the fitting. The hose won't go over the threads. So if you mark that hose just about there, and I'll show you a little secret. If I can't show you all my secrets, I'll have to kill you. Now you can see I've put my hose and I've clamped it down on a vise to hold it. There's other ways of holding them. This works very well for me because I can actually pull on the hose and keep the webbing of the hose tight. It'll actually shrink when you pull on it. If you push on it, the hose grows. And you want that hose as tight and as small as possible so that you're able to get the hose into the fitting. This is the problem a lot of people have, is getting the hose into the fitting in the right position. What I do is I have this strapping tape, just heavy string strapping tape, and what I'll do is I'll wrap it around the hose very tightly to keep that down tight. Now I've wrapped the tape around the hose, pulling on the hose and wrapping the tape very tightly. You can see it actually squashed the hose down smaller than the rest of the diameter. This will make it easier to put in to the fitting. And now we're going to have to cut this off. They make tools for cutting this. I just use an air saw. There. Carbide saw. And it makes a nice clean cut across the stainless steel wires. Now that I've got my line cut, I put my fitting, I've locked a socket. It's just a 3/4 inch socket, which the Earl fitting, or I'm using Summit, will fit in. This way, it makes it easier to push the hose. I'm gonna have to turn the camera off because I got to use both hands to push that hose down in there. But with the tape wrapped around it and it cuts smooth, it'll push in there pretty smoothly. I've got I forgot about my camera buddy. See, I can push the hose, get all the little stainless hairs inside, pushing down on it and turning it at the same time. Look in the fitting until the hose is at the bottom of the threads. Once it's at the bottom of the threads, now here's the next little secret I'm going to show you, is the hose will actually be a little bit tight for the male fitting to go into. So I use this, it's just a ream tool, and I'll go in there and I'll ream that rubber just a little bit. Just take a little bit of that rubber out of there. You see the rubber on my tool there. Make sure you blow these out with the air hose. And then the other fitting should screw right on in. And now that I've blown out with the air hose, I'll put just a couple drops of oil in there. The oil lubricates the rubber and also the threads, so that when you put this fitting in, you don't want to strip these threads off because they're only made out of aluminum. Push your fitting in there, pushing them together and turning it with that oil in there and cleaning it up with that little tapered tool. It goes in quite easily. Now I'll take the wrenches, tighten this down, and we'll put it on the bike. Now I've screwed the fitting down tight with my wrenches. And remember that tape we put around the tube to keep the wires from fraying and coming apart. I just take a razor blade, run around there with a razor blade, and peel it right off. So there, we've made up our fitting. And we put it into position, and by marking the hose, it's actually come out the right length. Might be a little bit snug on this one, but it's a very tight, short area to work with. So there you go. Good luck to you guys, you racers, and I hope that helps you out. Some simple little tricks to do the AN fittings with the stainless lines for your race bike. Good luck.